They are a precious group of young people, are they not?
Yes, they are. They're so special to us. So before we all dry up, freeze up, and lock up, and in my case, and in you, a lot of men's cases too, can't get it up. Yes, there you go, right there. And you know what? Once again, Captain Boomer Show is going to come through. I'm going to come through for you guys because, you know why? Because if you're having trouble with that can't get it up, you just get a hold of the Villages of Viagra. Yes, the Villages of Viagra will take care of you guys. I'm telling you, check them out because the Villages of Viagra, yes, where their motto is, guys, even a hard day is a good day. And a zap right into a big kiss for my cousin Susie out there because, well, wait a minute, I'm working on it. There we go. I hope this other button works better. There you go, babe. Big kiss for you. Yes, and right in the background music now, guess what we got here? I want to say it's the Dick Van Dyke Show. Yes, starring Dick Van Dyke, Mary Tyler Moore, and I don't know the rest of them. Yeah, well, anyway, there you go. Oh, Jane Mansfield. No, not Jane. No, I don't. Anyway, you know what I mean. Anyway, you know what I mean. Okay, we got to go on to Julia Childs. Yes, she was. She was on our show. Yes, and I can play a snippet of that for you if you don't mind. Here, I'll play it for you here. Hey, good morning, Captain. This is Julia Childs. Yes, you know, thank you for having me on your show. And I'm just going to be mentioning my new cookbook coming out because after all, marijuana will be legalized in your wonderful, wonderful state where you got 11 billion lakes or something over there. And God, how do you people walk around anyway? Aren't your feet wet all the time? I mean, come on. That's a hell of a lot of water. Anyway, Jesus. Hey, anyway, me and Betty Crocker back in the late 50s. Yes, Betty Crocker of the General Mills people. Yes, Betty Crocker and I got together and we came up with our own cookbook, Dilly Dilly. Yes, we did. And it's called simply Cooking with Mary Jane. Cooking with Mary Jane, yes. And I'm telling you, there's all sorts of good recipes for you guys. Because after all, it is going to be legalized, I predict, within the next year in the beautiful state of Minnesota. And don't forget, guys, I did once date Paul Bunyan. Yes, I did. Dilly dilly. Oh, there she is, the one and only Julia Child. You got to love that woman. A three-hour tour, that's it. How can those idiots get so lost in a three-hour tour? Huh? Oh, Jesus. Oh, yeah, I know the weather got bad, but, you know, whatever. Anyway, that's a story for another time. Gilligan's Island in itself is a whole world within itself. That Gilligan's Island is really, really cool. Okay, we got a big news here with another sponsor. You got Lunker Larry. Now, Lunker Larry, you guys have told you about him. Lunker Larry's product, it's called Lunker Larry's Rough Fish Rub. And that stuff there makes every fish that you take out of any body of water. I don't care what it is. A creek, a pond, a meadow, whatever you want to call it. A huge lake like Lake Superior. It doesn't matter. A mighty river like Mississippi. It don't matter. The pristine waters way up in Canada. It don't matter. Whatever you catch, take out of the water, you with Lunker Larry's fish rub, you guys can make it automatically taste like walleye. That is his main ingredient in this, and I can't divulge it. I don't know what it is myself. And I tried to get Lunker Larry to divulge it to me, but he said, ain't no way, Cap'n. I said, okay, I'll respect your privacy on that and your chance to make tons of money, but I want a kickback. No, I didn't say that. But anyway, yes, it makes all fish taste like walleye. And after all, isn't that what it's all about? Isn't that what it's all about? Okay, here we go. Would you rather catch a nice northern, a nice bass, or a nice walleye? Well, odds are that you would rather catch the walleye. Yes, But I'm telling you, walleyes are a little bit more tricky to catch than a northern. They're also a little more tricky to catch than a bass. But in the long run, that is the premier eating fish, without a doubt. Okay? So, if you can have any fish taste like that premier fish of our beloved Minnesota, why not? There you go. That's where Uncle Larry comes in, guys. You know, I can't put it any more plainer than that and any more, you know. So try it. You gotta love it. Yes, and you only heard it here. Okay, I'm gonna go on. I am gonna play a little rock and roll, I promise. But anyways, this show is called KC Jones and the Hummus. It's called KC Jones and the Hummus simply because through my medicated mind, VA medicated mind, by the way, I'm still waiting. I gotta wait 60 days to get therapy on my tendonitis wrist. So I said, the hell with that noise. I'll leave it as is, but you know, I think it's goddamn ridiculous. So total, by the time I got, I mentioned my wrist, went in, took x-rays and stuff and all this other shit. It'll be probably close to 5 months, almost 6 months before I can get anything going on my wrist. They gave me a couple shots and stuff like that. But I come to find out you can only get two in a lifetime, and I've already had two. First one worked great, second one sucked. I don't know what happened there. But anyway, yeah. Okay, there we go. I'm just glad I don't have to go in for brain surgery. Of course, I probably should go in for some brain surgery. I mean, I'm not going to doubt that one bit. Anyway. Oh, you guys hear the big news here? Forrest Gump. Yes, he did. Miss Jenny. He started his own ice cream company. Yes, he did. Started his own ice cream company, but he's getting a little bit of flack from people back in Greenville, Alabama. Because, and he had a survey out there, and I guess the survey came back for old Forrest. Ixnay on the brand new flavor that him and his company is coming out with. Forrest Gump started his own ice cream company. Yes, it did. It's called Bubba's Ice Cream, of course. But his flavor he came out was, the flavor was shrimp flavored ice cream. And his mother said, like she always does, stupid is as stupid does. So there you go, Forrest Gump's new ice cream. I could have told him it wasn't going to work if he just would have got a hold of the old captain here. Hell, doesn't take a genius to figure that one out. Ooh, Mission Impossible. I love it. Anyways, okay, 20 Mule Team Borax is going to be on one of our sponsors also. You remember those guys? Oh, yeah. I think they were with the Gunsmoke or whatever. Oh, and just to show you how crazy the world is nowadays, animated characters, Homer Simpson and his gang is the all-time most watched TV show ever. It just beat out Gunsmoke. So doesn't that kind of give you an idea of where our mentality is nowadays? Not my generation. Jesus God. Animated character in Homer walks around eating donuts and drinking beer. And, you know, he's got these characters and he hangs out at the bar and he works at a nuclear plant or something. I don't know. This is the number one show of all time. Buku fucking Dinky Dow, okay? Let's Diddy Mow. Diddy Mow, baby. Diddy Mow. Woo! Cuckoo, cuckoo, Diddy Mow. Oh, man. Anyway, okay, I got off on a little run here. Okay, well, maybe I'll play some rock and roll here, okay, guys? I'm sorry. We'll play a little rock and roll, baby. After all, this one is called, Rock and Roll of the 60s. And I'm not going to say nothing. Because I screw it up all the time anyway. it's what I do. Oh, boy. Got a little rain out there, but we need it. We'll take it. We'll take that rain. Oh, baby. Here we go, baby. You make my heart sing.
show. Come on, hold me tight. I love you.
For sure.
Come on, hold me tight. You move me.
Yeah, wild thing.
Yeah, I hear me a few wild things, I tell you that. Oh boy.
Yeah. Anyway. Okay, hey, let's just. I got another classic right here. I hope you like this one, guys. This is the summer of 66. Best year of my life. I loved it. It was a great summer. It really was. Anyway, we're going to be playing a little bit of, I believe it's Red Rubber Ball. Well, blow me down. Well, blow me down. Thank you.
And I did very well. I screwed up and I put in a karaoke. I'm sorry, it's no jokey. I really screwed it up. I forgot to look at the label. A red rubber ball. I should have known you bid me farewell. There's a lesson to be learned from this, and I learned it very well. Now I know you're not the only starfish in the sea. If I forget with my life, and that's all that's left to be. And I think the worst is over now. Yeah, la 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 la, the morning sun is shining like a red rubber ball. Lesson to do 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 do. Bought my ticket with my tears, and that's all I'm gonna spend. Worst is over now. The worst is over now. The morning sun is shining like a red rubber ball. Yeah, the worst is over now. The morning sun is shining like a red rubber ball.